So do you guys know what is a rigging plan and what it comprises of? So I thought I'd make a video on this as well. Sometimes you're asked this question regarding rigging plan or cargo work. So a rigging plan should be available to rig the lifting appliances like heavy derricks or cranes. Now this is particularly in reference to the derricks because derricks are required to be rigged. And if ships are more and more ships these days, they don't have the derricks anymore. Derricks are becoming obsolete. But if you are still sailing on ships on which heavy derricks are carried out or heavy derricks are present, you need to have a rigging plan in place. So practically such derricks are rigged in shipyard and they are never unrigged. So the ship basically keeps using the same rigging that are provided from the shipyard. But in case, if you require to rig in case of repairs of a wire being replaced, then in such a case the rigging plan should be consulted, because once it is rigged from the shipyard, it will not stay like that forever, because the wires with the use and wear and tear, they get worn out and they have to be sometimes replaced. And once you replace the wires, you of course have to re-rig the derrick. In that case the rigging plan has to be referred to. Any renewal of parts should also conform to the specifications as per the rigging plan, which are prepared by the derrick or the crane manufacturers. The derrick plan, or the rigging plan rather, should contain the following information. It should contain information about the position and size of the deck eye plates, the position of inboard and outboard booms, maximum headroom permissible, which is basically permissible height of cargo hook above hatch combing, then the maximum angle between the runner wires, the position size and the safe working load of the blocks, the length, size and safe working load of the runners, topping lifts, guys and preventers, and the safe working load of the shackles that are being used. It should also tell you about the position of derricks that at which they produce the maximum forces, and the optimum position for guys and preventers to resist such maximum forces. Then continued load diagrams showing forces for a load of 1 ton or the safe working load are provided as well. And finally, the guidance on the maintenance of derrick rig is also included in the rigging plan.